Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're like me and you have an old tractor like the one back behind me, and you've done something like I did and put a front end loader on it, well, it may not have enough weight in the back end. Mine spins the tires a lot. And so today I'm putting in ballast weight, and I'm using 20 below windshield washer fluid, and I've hooked up a little pump, and I thought I'd show you quickly how that works. As you can see, I'm using my sprayer rig, and you know, those have a little pump on them like that right there, and they work by pressure. And what I've done is I took my wand off. You see my wand laying there. I took my wand off and I ran the hose over here to a manifold that I made. And let me explain this manifold to you. You see over there on the right hand side at the bottom where the black hose goes in, there is a shutoff valve, and that's really important. I don't think, frankly, that this little pressure gauge that I put in there worked. It doesn't even work. It was irrelevant and unnecessary. But I put it in. I saw somebody made one on YouTube, and I copied that. But the important thing here is that it comes in, goes up through there, and goes in through this adapter valve, and you have to buy one of these adapter valves to go on your tire. And what you do is you take the valve stem out of that valve core. You take the valve stem out and you put that adapter on there, and that's a water adapter. But instead of using this little pressure release right here to release the air ever so often, what I did was I came back down, as you can see, to the left. And I came back down and I put me in another cutoff switch and that clear piece of hose. And that clear piece of hose allows me to see what's coming out. And so what I do is I run this thing for 15 or 20 minutes and allow it to pump in the fluid. But while it's doing that, it's displacing air and it's building up pressure. And so ever so often you need to stop, turn your system off, shut this valve off, and then come over and open this valve. And when you do, let's see if I can see anything now. Yeah. Did you see that? Some fluid comes out, and then the air leaks out. But instead of just spilling it out on the ground, I've run it in a garden hose, and I run it back into my reservoir over there so I don't lose any. And I'm using a deep cycle battery there to run my system. And so it works pretty good. Let me turn this back off and I'll show you kind of how this works. That one's on, this one's off. System's ready to go. So, turn it from off to on. The little pump is pumping. I keep adding fluid here. Keep the tank up, and I have to put three of these tanks in there, 43 gallons in each tire. And you ask me, how do I know? Well, I looked online. There is a there's a chart online that tells you just exactly how much that you have to put in each tire. And by the way, you notice that I have, let's see here, I have a jack and a jack stand right there. You have to jack the tire up off of the ground and allow it to be able to turn freely. And you put the, obviously, you can see, you put the valve stem up at 12 o'clock so that the fluid will come in and go down around and fill up the tires and come up, and what little bit of air will be left will be up there at the top. And you fill those up to about 75%. And my tires the size that they are, takes 43 gallons. And believe me, it's not a fast process. It's taken me, it took me, I think, close to 3 hours to do the other wheel over there, the other tire. So I'll be here for a while. But I hope you are able to see how I did it. You can do it with any other little pump. And it, whenever I finish, I'll put my wand back on right there. I'll put my wand back on and clean out my tank and be able to use it for herbicides, pesticides, or liquid fertilizer or whatever on the farm. And you may ask, what's that gallon jug over there with the blue funnel? Well, every now and then that little manifold up at the very top drips, particularly when the pressure gets up. And the more it drips, the more I know to go over and turn it off and cycle the air back out of it and let the pressure get back down low again, and then just go ahead and pump more fluid in. But that's how I'm doing it. And so I hope this helps some of you guys. So there you go. I hope that helps. If any of you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. We really appreciate you watching our channel. Thanks a million. God bless you. Have a great day.